So I've been hearing that plants make people happy all the time. So here I am doing my job for you in the Southport Corridor neighborhood, Tom Barnes, Chicago scene at the Sill. Play on words for plants, of course, right here at Roscoe in Southport. I'm going to talk to Eliza, giving me the scoop on all things plants and helping making you happy for the Chicago scene. All right, so I've made my way inside the Sill, appropriately named enough for all the plants that you might want to put on your sill and not kill. Eliza and her folks here at the Sill will help you figure out how to keep everything going, right, Eliza?
That's absolutely right.
So tell me quick, this new addition to Chicago, like what's your plans on, what do you want to accomplish with this store for people coming in, checking it out for the first time?
So we are a neighborhood plant store and biophilic design company, and we are looking to connect more folks in Chicago to nature in the plants, with the plants that we have here.
Right, so I think a lot of people that come, you know, every spring, you know, they were like, oh, let's go out and get some plants, and then they end up like killing them in 2 weeks. And there's a lot of reasons for that. Absolutely. Not everybody has a green thumb and knows more than your average person. You certainly can't get that at like big box stores. That's why you want to do something here a little bit more intimate, where you can teach your customers things, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So I started the Sill in 2012 as a way to actually educate people like myself who are really interested in plants but didn't know how to approach the category. Where do I start? What kind of light do I have? Am I gonna be able to keep that alive? How often do I water it? What is it even called? And you couldn't get those types of answers anywhere. And so I started the Sill to be a very friendly and approachable way to connect people with nature through houseplants.
And some of those things that you offer up are for people who might be starting off for the first time. Maybe they moved to the city and they got maybe a little deck on the, or a porch on the back of their apartment. You have something for that, or for something who's out in the burbs who want to, you know, fill up their backyard. You have everything kind of in certain areas where it says like bright light or low light and stuff like that, right?
Yeah, so you can shop by light, you can shop by size. We have the plants, we have the pots, we have potting soil, we have tools, accessories, care. We have an incredibly knowledgeable staff. And we have plants that can go inside or outside during warm months only. And we have succulents and tropical plants. We have pet-friendly plants. Sometimes people don't even know that you're supposed to shop for pet-friendly plants. If you have a curious cat or a dog who's gonna get into your plant, you wanna make sure that it's safe for your plants, for your pets rather. Right. So we have all of that. And we organize the store in a way that's really easy to shop on your own. But of course, again, we have our super knowledgeable staff who can't wait to help everyone here become plant parents, as we call them. And I thought that it was always interesting to actually combine sort of the elements of plants, their wellness and their health benefits, with the home decor element to really make it an intrinsic part of your space.
Right, you want to give your house, I mean, it's supposed to be your sanctuary, your place of rest, and plants have a big part in that, and so do pets, and so do babies for young families. That's why you do offer, you just said earlier, you know, pet friendly, and odds are that if it's pet friendly, it might be kid friendly for the kids who might also be curious, right?
Exactly, there's always a curious kid around, and we always recommend pet friendly plants for that as well. But you know, plants are great for the home. We're starting to return to the office too, so people are coming in curious about getting plants for their offices. So plants really belong in all spaces. They make great gifts, they make great activities, fun for your kids to teach them about plants. We're gonna start hosting workshops this fall, everything from your basic houseplant care to more activity-based terrarium building, to even plant-themed workshops like watercoloring your plants.
Yeah, and I think that what you said there, your staff being knowledgeable, I think that's a big factor for a lot of people who might be intimidated by the whole plant buying process.
Yes.
You know, almost similar to like, even like if you think of like a record store where you go and you don't know anything about records, but you will listen to the staff because they'll point you in the right direction.
Yeah.
Same thing here. Yeah,
they're gonna staff picks actually. We have a table up front that has all of our staff picks. And I think the most important thing is that nobody here is gonna make you feel inadequate about not knowing about plants. Nobody is born with a green thumb. Nobody is born knowing about plants. You have to learn. You have to practice. You probably have to kill a plant or two, and that's totally okay. We don't judge you if you've killed a plant. We're totally here just to educate.
Yeah, so you remove the snobbery of all of it, right? Like this, where you want it to be a relaxed environment, you know, with the decoration, you've incorporated plants into the space. And this isn't just for like the people starting off. If there are people watching right now that are seasoned veterans, you have certain things here that might be hard to find for some people. You know, certainly you mentioned one earlier.
Variegated Monstera, which is a very hot ticket item because it's very rare.
Mm-hmm.
We also have fun plants like unique cacti. We have angel wing begonias. We have some interesting Hoya varieties and Calatheas. So not just for beginners. I think there's something for everyone.
For people who want information about this, because you did start off online years ago, and here you are, 6 location. You have them spread out over the United States. So the in-store experience is, has proven to still be valuable. That's why you open this, for those workshops, to teach people so they can come back and enjoy plant life. So what's the best way for people to find you guys?
Yeah, at thesill.com, if you want to learn more about our company and shop online, certainly come to Southport, visit the store. We hope to expand here in Chicago. We also have stores in New York, LA, and San Francisco.
And you said, when are the workshops going to start up again?
Workshops will resume in the fall. We also do online workshops currently.
Amazing. Thank you very much for taking the time to show me around. I appreciate it.
Come by and visit.
All right, that's all things happening at the Sill, T-B-A-R-N-A-S at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, that's T-Barnes at WGNTV.com. Happy planting, everybody.